Most Q-types in Beyond are generators. This means they generate shapes, text, drawings, etc., and the generation is done every frame of calculation. While this has worked well in the past, as your keys become more and more complex, the calculation time for each frame will drastically increase, especially when you have large numbers of lasers in your setup. Parametric image Q-types are different. Instead of generating your content, it uses basic shapes and Q-types that are sourced from and rendered as frames. This is done before effects and greatly reduces calculation time. If you're having concerns about performance or your show has many lasers in it, you should use parametric images over QuickShape wherever possible. To create a parametric image, right-click on an empty Q cell and click New Parametric Image. Like all different content types, on the top left you have the option to create a new, open, and save for this image, publish to the cloud, change its properties, view options, capture, and pause. On the top right you have a Show It Now and Zone Selection. On the left area you have the preview for your shape, and on the right we have your shape settings under the Settings tab, and all of your effects under the Effects tab. As parametric images are based on frames instead of generations, under Shape you can select from a list of different base shapes, and below that you'll have the parameters related to that shape. As you can see, there are many shape types for different uses, and the best way to know them is to explore. For this video, we will cover the shapes you will want that replace the use for shapes made in the Simple Shape Editor. Beam is fairly simple and just a single hot point where you can control its point count, position, hue, saturation, and brightness. For lines, we have a couple options. Simplest is line AB, where you can control the line points, anchor points, position, and its overall color. If you want separate control of anchors to the line, use number 9, the line. With this, you can control similar parameters, but you're able to control the color of the anchors and line separately. For circles, you can use ellipse or ellipse multiloop. Ellipse is a normal circle with an overall size, point, and color control, and you can also control the start and finish overlap to clean up the seam. Multiloop allows you to draw the circle over and over in the same frame to smooth out seams and improve how the circle looks when it moves at fast speeds. You can control the number of turns and optimize blanking. For squares, use rectangle AB. Here you can control its overall point count, its start anchor and corner anchors, its side positioning, and control its overall color. For triangles, or any other number of side shapes, use polygon. Here you can set how many sides it has, its start angle, size, and color options, as well as how dense the anchors on the corners are. There are many other options, so feel free to take a look after this video. They all follow the similar path of the shape and its parameters. Once you have the shape you would like, you can go to the Effects tab and add any effect to the shape you would like, just like any other Q-type. It is important to note you can use parametric images inside of synth images as well to help make your very complex cues perform much faster. And you can use parametric images anywhere and beyond where you can use the simple shapes, as we see this being a replacement for the simple shape editor in many cases. Thanks for watching our quick hints video on the parametric image Q-type. If you still have questions, feel free to contact support by emailing support@pangolin.com.